Disconnected. Disconnected. You're disconnected. Disconnected. Make the heart responder, then obliterate. Just a small reminder. When the Arctic land in Antarctica,
Buzzy and the Banshees. But there are the Creatures from Disconnected, and that album will be out probably in September, keeping the spirit of that music alive. Our next artists have been on in
Some men will break their bones, don't know how to build stable homes. Those men will break your bones, don't know how to build stable homes.
Don't know how to build stable homes.
MP Jay Harvey, accompanied by the Visual Ministry Choir there. That was from the Angels of Dirty Faces LP and the Broken Homes. We'll be hearing more from them later, but first, let's have some chittle-chattle with a great guest, Mr. Mick Hucknall, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the show, Mick.
Thank you.
Your new record is called, your new LP is called Blue. Why is that?
Well, it was a bit of a blue year last year. A lot of things happened for me, and the lyrics and the songs kind of go along with the mood that was happening with me at that time.
Now, you've got, which I didn't know, but you're involved with a reggae label.
Blood and Fire.
Yeah. When did you first get an interest and enthusiasm for that music?
Oh, God, I've been listening to that stuff since I was about 17, 1977. And I used to collect old Jamaican pre's, you know, 45s with the dubs on the B-sides. And we always wanted to get involved somehow in a label to release this stuff. And with the help of Steve Barrow, we got to meet a lot of people in Jamaica, and then we found out where these masters were. Some of them are hiding in, like, chicken shacks and stuff like that all over the place. And I think the artists in Jamaica are really proud to be part of it because they're finally getting paid instead of getting shot.
Hey, they're recognised.
Indeed.
Yeah, it's a good thing. Well, I think we've got... tell us about your favourite singers, I would you say? Favourite reggae singers.
Reggae singers. Yeah. Burning Spear, Big Youth. Mm-hmm. Culture, band called Culture. I mean, I like Toasters as well as singers, so I love Horace Andy, I like Prince Farai. People from the golden age of reggae in the mid-70s.
Yeah.
Lee Scratch Perry.
I was hoping you'd say Gregory Isaacs.
Oh, it's not bad, is it?
No, we've got some film with it.
I've done one of these tunes, yeah.
I need attendance from my nurse around the clock. Cause there's no prescription for me. She's the one, the only remedy. My night nurse, make it quick. Oh, the pain is getting worse.
Now, you quite rightly wondered what that was off, and I can tell you that I don't know. But it did have a lovely sort of mid-70s look to it, didn't it?
Yeah,
I enjoyed very much, those orange lights and the green lights.
They used to call him the cool ruler.
Yeah. Well, you've had him on, he was good. In fact, now, speaking of Jamaican music, of course, we are going to... this is what we should address, because Rico Rodriguez posted me, a Jamaican trombonist who's worked with you, and we are going to work together, aren't we? Tomorrow night, in fact. I think the public should know this, because it is an event, because you and I, on behalf of Britain, we'll be playing to all of the world leaders of the G8.
Yeah, playing for Boris and the boys, right?
Boris and
we've got to see if we can get him up and dance like he does in Russia, you know.
Do you think that would be nice? Like it, all that?
That
would be, when they do that dance with their legs, go like that.
Huh?
And their legs do that. Do you think he'd do that?
We'll make him move. We'll get him up.
And maybe if we get our photograph, I could show it on the programme next week.
I'm just going to check out Boris and see if he's sober.
Have you met Bill before?
He's probably sober.
Yeah,
I think he's
as a judge. Maybe you'll come up and play the saxophone.
You can do that. Yeah. You're the band leader guy.
Yeah, exactly.
You
know? It'll be a later, but for world leaders. Before we just go on, you're going to be... What's the next song you're going to be doing? You're going to be doing it at the piano with your pianist. What song is that?
Yeah, it's a song called Someday in My Life. And David Whittaker, who's playing the piano, did the string arrangement for it on the album.
Where does that come from, that song?
I wrote it on an aeroplane going to Italy. I actually wrote it for an Italian singer called Mina, who's like the kind of Edith Piaf of Italy.
Yeah.
And she's quite a legend, you know. We went over to Switzerland and recorded the song with her, and I also did do my version on the album.
Right. Well, we'll look forward to hearing that, and in the meantime, thank you very much, Mick Hucknall.
Cheers.
Mick will be performing again later. We're looking forward to. And I'll be looking forward to seeing him with the world leaders tomorrow night. I'll be reporting back to you what that event was like on next week's programme. Now please welcome back the Smashing Pumpkins. What did you learn from him?
It's just a matter of style and grace, I guess, mainly.
Great lovely thing to learn from the master. Now you also played on a great deal of Phil Spector sessions with the Riots and the Crystals and Mr. Tambourine Man, you played on that. But with what were the Phil Spector sessions like?
It was sort of an amazing large group of people in a small room, four pianos and five guitars, sometimes two drums.
All playing the same thing?
Yeah, all at the same time. It's very astonishing, really.
Very effective and interesting, because tonight we've got a band with two bass players, the three of us here, and the Smashing Pumpkins have got almost three drummers. So that adds to that too. So was the idea of it to play, although you'd have three pianos, they'd all be sat playing the same?
No, they're playing different things, but still quite a big sound.
Yeah. Now, of course, your own shows are huge concert draws. What's the philosophy behind your shows when you do a short show?
A large show, you mean?
Yeah.
You have a lot of people that it's easier. If you have a small group, they have to play sort of precise things. Mm-hmm. You have a large band, that covers up the mistakes, kind of like the government, you know?
Yeah. And now, of course, in the early 70s, there was the Mad Dogs and Englishmen tour, and that was a huge tour. How many people were on that tour?
We started out with 45. We had to cut it down a little bit in the middle. It got a little bit tedious, but with all the dancers and singers, we had all those people on the stage at once.
Now, later, you're going to be doing some of your songs for us, but you have written, of course, A Song For You, Delta Lady, Tightrope Masquerade, and of course A Song For You was covered by both Aretha Franklin and Ray Charles. So all these people have done your songs. Which is your favorite of your songs, the song you're most proud of?
Well, I suppose that one, I like that song a lot. I actually wrote that, I was trying to write a song that Ray Charles and Frank Sinatra could both sing. Mm-hmm. So I was pleased that he did that.
And you've accompanied all these people, you've played with them and worked with them. What is that, you know, people like Frank Sinatra or Ray Charles, who, you know, but that. What is the similarity between those people? What is it? What makes them alike?
Well, there were no armed guards at Ray Charles' session, for one thing. But each one of them had its own sort of glamour, I suppose. Mm-hmm. I enjoyed playing with Sam Cooke, mm-hmm. with Don Costa, and Johnny Mathis.
Mm-hmm. And you've got a record out at the moment, which. Is under your country pseudonym of Hank Wilson, and I think this is the third Hank Wilson record.
Yeah.
Where does Hank Wilson come from, this alter ego character?
It's just a bit of simple misdirection. It's kind of a combination of Hank Williams and Hank Thompson.
Yeah, and I do enjoy a bit of simple misdirection, mischievous misdirection. That's a great thing. And you've done songs on it with Willie Nelson, I believe. Now, he's an old friend of yours. When did you first meet him?
I guess I've known him about 20 years. I actually played on some of his records before I met him.
Mm-hmm. In a moment, we're going to play In a Piano Experiment. What are the two numbers that you're going to be playing for us?
Well, the first one is the title song of that record called Legend in My Time. Mm-hmm. And then the other one is the old Joe Cocker song, A Delta Lady.
We're looking forward to that, and we'll look forward to hearing those very much shortly. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Leon Russell. So we'll be doing a piano duet experiment with Mr. Leon Russell, and while he prepares, let's go back to Susie and Budgie, who have got together the first time on British television with just two or three rehearsals that were only that long. Welcome back, The Creatures.